Good evening and welcome to Durham Cathedral, the shrine of St Cuthbert, for our service of choral evensong this evening. A warm welcome to you if you are within the cathedral and also if you are joining us online. The responses this evening are to a setting by Philip Moore, and the Magnificat and Nunc Dimittis, as with the introit, are by Charles Villiers Stanford.
Praise ye the Lord.
My Lord, send me praise.
The psalms appointed for this fourth evening are Psalms 22 and 23, and we sit for the choir singing those psalms.
Thank you. The first lesson is written in the second chapter of the book of the prophet Isaiah, beginning to read from the first verse. The word that Isaiah, son of Amoz, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In days to come, the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established as the highest of the mountains, and shall be raised above the hills. All the nations shall stream to it. Many people shall come and say, "Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths." For out of Zion shall go forth instruction, and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. He shall judge between the nations, and shall arbitrate for many people. They shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war any more. O house of Jacob, come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. For you have forsaken the ways of your people, O house of Jacob. Indeed, they are full of diviners from the east and of soothsayers like the Philistines, and they clasp hands with foreigners. Their land is filled with silver and gold, and there is no end to their treasures. Their land is filled with horses, and there is no end to their chariots. Their land is filled with idols. They bow down to the work of their hands, to what their own fingers have made. And so people are humbled, and everyone is brought low. Do not forgive them. Enter into the rock, and hide in the dust from the terror of the Lord and from the glory of his majesty. The haughty eyes of people shall be brought low, and the pride of everyone shall be humbled, and the Lord alone will be exalted on that day. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. The second lesson is taken from the second chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 16th verse. This passage, which includes the massacre of the innocents, is usually read just after Christmas. It's part of the narrative of Matthew's Gospel that we're reading at the moment. When Herod saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, he was infuriated, and he sent and killed all the children in and around Bethlehem who were 2 years old or under, according to the time that he had learned from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken through the prophet Jeremiah. A voice was heard in Ramah, wailing and loud lamentation, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be consoled because they are no more. When Herod died, an angel of the Lord suddenly appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who are seeking the child's life are dead. Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was ruling over Judea in the place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. And after being warned in a dream, he went away to the district of Galilee. There he made his home in a town called Nazareth, so that what had been spoken through the prophets might be fulfilled. He will be called a Nazarene. Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you. sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of our body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Shed thy mercy upon us,
and grant us thy salvation.
O Lord, save the Queen. Thy ministers with righteousness.
And make my soul thy joy, as thy joy.
O Lord, save thy people. In our time, O Lord,
because there is no other that frighteneth us but
only God. O God, make clean our hearts within us. Grant, we beseech thee, merciful Lord, to thy faithful people pardon and peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve thee with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee, we being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy, defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The anthem this evening is again by Charles Villiers Stanford and is a setting of words by Habakkuk written at the time of the impending invasion by the Chaldeans for Lo, I Raise Up. This was composed in 1914 but not published until Stanford had died and was published in 1939.
Thank you.
Let us pray. As we prepare ourselves for the restrictions that take place later this evening and this time of engaging with the pandemic in this new way, keep us, good Lord, under the shadow of your mercy in this time of uncertainty and distress. Sustain and support the anxious and fearful, and lift up all who are brought low, that we may rejoice in your comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. We pray for the nations of this world, praying especially at this time for the peoples of the United States of America as they await the results of their election. We pray for all the leaders of the nations. Almighty God, who alone givest wisdom and understanding, inspire, we pray thee, the minds of all to whom thou hast committed the government of the nations of the world. Give them the vision of truth and justice, that by their counsels all races and classes may work together, and thy church throughout the world may serve thee in freedom and peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We pray for all places of healing, for care homes and nursing homes, hospitals and surgeries. Most merciful Father, who has taught us to love thee with all our strength, and to glorify thee in our bodies, we commend to thee for thy continual blessing the hospitals of our land and those who serve in them. Prosper all that is being done for the healing of the sick, the conquest of disease, and the training of doctors and nurses, that thy will may be done in the relief of suffering and the making of lives whole, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We bring to Almighty God those who weigh heavy upon our hearts and minds, those who have been prayed for in this place during this day. Abide with us, Lord, for it is toward evening and the day is far spent. Abide with us and with thy whole church. Abide with us in the end of the day, in the end of our life, and in the end of the world. Abide with us in thy grace and bounty, with thy holy word and sacrament, with thy comfort and blessing. Abide with us when cometh the night of affliction and fear, the night of doubt and temptation, the night of bitter death. Abide with us and with all thy faithful ones, O Lord, in time and in eternity. Amen. Amen. We join all our prayers together in the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you for joining with us for our service of choral evensong, both those of you who have joined with us within the cathedral and those who have joined with us online. Morning prayer will be live streamed at 8:30, and then choral evensong tomorrow will also be live streamed at 5:15. We will no longer be able to have public acts of worship, and we will be reverting back to live streaming only. To access these, you go to either the cathedral's website or the cathedral's page on Facebook, and you will then be able to join with us as we pray for our communities. Those within the cathedral, if you could leave via the north aisle at the end of the service, we would be very grateful to you.